Hey guys, Inder this side from 24x7 Everything. Hope you all are doing great. We are again back with another video on ASUS ZenFone Max Pro M1, and this time it's related to how to download or how to update manually from version 340, that is from Oreo, then version 053, 055, 056 and 057 to very latest version, that is 058. So for this part, it's recommendable to those users who haven't got this particular FOTA update. So at my end, I am getting the FOTA update, but in this particular video, I will show how to manually update it. So let's skip this FOTA part. But before that, let me show you on which version I am on it at this moment. So let me zoom it. So at this moment, it's showing 1906, then 057. So we will be updating from 057 to 058. As I've already told, you can update from 340, 050, 053, 055, 056, 057 to your latest update, that is 058. And before that, let me show you there were some issue related to the Widevine certification. So it was L3, in 058 it will be changed to L1. So that has been resolved. And apart from this, let me show you the camera to probe API, that what's our camera to API status at this moment. It is showing legacy, so it's not enabled. So that will also clear the doubt of the other users, that whether after updating it, it will enable or not. It will not, but we will again come back after updating it. Now let's move to my blog, from where we can download the actual file from the official ASUS server rather than any other hosting. So the link for this particular blog will be shared in the description below. You can click on it and navigate to this particular thing, and on this you will find this particular change log. Let me discuss this rapidly. So fix the screen rotation flickering issue in this update in latest 058. Yes, it has been. Widevine L1 will be back once we'll update it. At this moment it is showing L3. Fix the battery drain issue. No, this particular issue is not resolved. On the contrary, battery drain is at peak at this moment. Sound quality is improved. Yes, it has improved as compared to version 056 and 057, but it's not as good as the Android Oreo version, that is 340. Apart from the slow charging issue, yes, that has also been fixed. Fingerprint scanning is, yes, it has also been issued, and it is working absolutely fine and as well as faster. So now let's move how to download. So this is the link, that is official ASUS server URL. You can even view dlcd.asus.com. This is the actual servers. This is actual official ASUS server, and from where which I have put the link here. So you just have to tap on it, and once you will tap it, it will ask you, do you want like storage and so on. Afterward, it will prompt you, do you want to download file? If you want to, then it will by default keep it into download. So as we had already downloaded, so I will cancel it. So let me move to the file manager. You can move to any file manager whatsoever you have installed. So we are using this ASUS own file manager. So in this, this is the download folder. So that particular file is already been downloaded at our site with the version 058.user.zip. Now you just have to do one thing. Just select this, and afterward just copy to internal storage. So for that, you will be navigating to your internal storage, and afterward you will be copying it here. As we had already copied it, so I'll be skipping this part, and let me show you that as well, that where I have put. So I am going to internal storage. So it's in root. So it's the same file, 058.user.zip file. So after doing this, you don't have to do anything. Just press on power button and restart your phone. As soon as your phone will be restarted, a prompt will be given to you on the login screen that a system update file has been updated. Do you want to update or not? So let's wait for 2 to 3 seconds until our phone will be rebooted. In the meantime, we had already created numerous videos on this particular latest version, that is 058, using FOTA update. Then we had also created a review. Then before that, there was an initial update in which we have discussed all those points and so on. So now let's wait. So at this moment, so now at your end, you will see this sort of prompt, that system update file detected. So as I'm also getting FOTA service, you won't be getting this. If you are getting FOTA, you can directly click on this rather than this. So as the agenda of this video is how to manually update it, so I'll be clicking on here. So as soon as I'll be clicking, it will show me that this is the update package. Yes, you have to click on OK. Now it will start, it will prepare your system to update this particular version, that is from 0.57 to 0.15. So this is a full firmware, so it's usually of 1.5 GB. So if someone is on very, like on a daily data packs where they are not having the enough data pack, like more than 1.5 GB, then they can wait till the FOTA update will be available. This particular method will be useful for the ones who are not having any restriction in terms of data. So now the system will start updating itself, as it is showing installing system update. So we'll again come back once we will reach into the last steps of update, and afterward we'll continue our discussion on this. So finally the update has been installed. Now it will be rebooted, and it will take 5 to 6 seconds to actually log into the login screen. So let's wait till that time, and in the meantime we can discuss other things as well. So by using this particular method, you will be able to update your phone from any version starting from 340, that is Android 340, till 0.57. So let's wait till the time we'll boot to the login. Voila, we have been logged into the login screen. Now it's showing finishing system update. So this is just an integral, like this is an integral part. So after this, you will be getting this prompt that your system has been updated successfully. Just click on OK, and afterward move to the settings section to see whether our system has been updated to latest version or not. Although it will be just for the confirmation part. So let me move to the system, then about phone. Then after that, Android version 9, and now you will be able to view our build number is showing 16.2017.1908.058. Earlier it was 1906.057, and now it's 1908.058. So finally, you have updated, or you have updated your phone from the previous versions 340, 050, 053, 055, 056, 057, and so on. So let me close this, and now we'll move to the other parts that we had already discussed, that after this update we'll see whether camera to EPA is enabled or not. So I've just opened that particular camera to probe EPA. It is showing legacy, so no, there is no camera to EPA is enabled after updating this update. So you can share this video with all the YouTubers who are creating this unnecessary mess by saying that camera to EPA is enabled in this particular update, so they can even know that. You all might be thinking that I have created this repeatedly camera to API related thing, but this is necessary so that users won't be in dilemma that whether they have been they need to update or not only on the basis of camera to API. And apart from this, let's verify this wideband CDN certificate as well. So earlier it was showing L3, now it's L1. So finally it is also upgraded from L3 to L1. Now you can be able to stream your HD content on your phone. So this was all from our side, that how to manually update your phone from Oreo 340, then Pi 050, Pi 053, Pi 055, Pi 056, Pi 057 to the latest Pi version, that is 058. Hope you like this video. If you really like this video, kindly share this with your friends and family, and apart from this, please subscribe to our channel, because this will surely motivate us and boost us to create more videos like this in the coming future. It's the time to sign off now. Bye for now. Thanks.